This will be the last time I'll be talking about the United States of America in 2024. In 2025, we are going to have a lot of challenges in the country called the United States of America. I can't be serious. We must laugh. May BP, no kid person, all in the name of Prophet. He talks to me freely, so I say it very easily. Let's pray, because the female gender is coming to rule the United States of America. The final decisions have been made. So if you like, you abuse me. If you like, you don't abuse me. You said the female gender should rule. It's okay. She will rule. But America will go through challenges. A very, very high challenges. So we must pray for the United States of America. The moment, the time, the days, the months, the year is in 2025, prophecy about the United States of America. The United States of America dollar will be falling. Write it down. You are live with me. Dollar will make no value. White pounds will be increasing. But I bet you the Arab money will go higher than the pounds and the dollar. And dollars will fall drastically. And it's going to be history where we are going to see America with so much debt. America will be in so much debt in 2025 ending by this time. Nigeria will also be in debt, but America own will be growing so fast and fast and fast. And let us also pray the world power will slightly, mistakenly, boldly, all the English language, walk out from their hands. In 2025, they will fall out of the world power. No nations will respect the Americans anymore. That's the third or the fourth one. And the Lord began to show me in 2025 and beyond, as much as the lady is the president, and I began to see crops dying. In agriculture, we have no power in the United States of America. The agriculture issues will be a challenge in the United States of America. That the cultural side, which is the agriculture, I mean to say, will become a problem. Oh, let's come to Africa. Let's begin to bring fruit from Africa. So we need to pray for the United States of America, because their agriculture will fall. Their money, their value for the money will fall. A lot of things will fall. We will experience a lot of things. Yeah. These are more homeless people. Homeless people. Homeless people. More homeless people. More homeless people in the United States of America. The economy is going down, in which you're going to compare an African country to the American country. That's what the Lord is talking about. So we should be very careful. And if everybody is in America, it's time for them to also start coming back home to plant some investment, because when things might and will and must so difficult in America, people will choose to come back home to survive until the economy is better. So the economy is going down. So many calamities are coming. Oh, they call them the mucus. Mucus is also coming in the United States of America. We are going to see a lot of end time signs in that nation. And I bet you, it's not excluded with what I call the murder. The killing every day will be times two of what have been happening. The killings in the United States of America will be times two. That is what the Lord is talking about. I'm talking about when the lady Kamala becomes the president of America. There are going to be more than nine plagues that will make them suffer. So it's a decision for you two people to fight me or insult me as usual, but at the end we will see what the Lord has said. The United States of America will never be the same. Can I give you the sign? This American election will look like a Nigerian election. Yeah, the first in the history where American election will not go as well. It's going to be like an African election, where you will see them fighting for issues physically. So we should be very careful. And if time is not taken, the election will be shifted. If time is not taken, the election will be what? Will be shifted. So we need to be careful. If time is not taken, the United States of America will shift the election for corruption, because that woman is coming to power by corruption, not by election. That is what I'm here to tell you. So we need to pray for the United States of America, that death will be so rampant, very, very rampant, very, very rampant. The death in America will be so high that there are numbers of people dying, gang war, sicknesses, strange sicknesses, and all of that. And the Lord is talking about in the same 2025, that gay people, the gays, will experience a certain different sickness. It's not the normal sickness we are experiencing. A sickness is going to come out next year, 2025, that will only go rampant with gay. It has never been in the history of gay, but I see gay having a specific disease in 2025. So we should pray. What could that be? I have no idea. But in 2025, we will experience a new gay disease. That's what the Lord is talking about. And of course, you should know it's coming from the United States of America and beyond, and other nations, and those diseases will be a problem. And as I said before, the agriculture will fall in the United States of America. So we should keep praying. What will happen between love marriage and court marriage in 2025? In 2025, a lot of young men would decide, and we be willing to raise up the rights to flag up marriages without court marriage. They will say they will stand for the love, not for the cult. So we're going to have a lot of issues where even the prenup is not even sure of that. Cult marriage versus love marriage. Are we getting married because of the love, or we are getting married because of the cult? That will be seen in 2025 and beyond, where a lot of people would not want to get married in court marriage. Nobody would want to share 50-50 and come as a gold digger and go as a winner. The Lord said all that is changing in 2025. There's a lot of people that will come out and say, no, we want things to be equal. Our men are tired of losing their wealth, their property, their integrity, because they married in court. So this is a marriage in the church or the court for the society. That is what is going to happen in 2025 and beyond. It might not start immediately, but it will continue. Including in 2025, the weather will be worse than what we have experienced in 2024. In 2025, the weather will be worse, or worse, if my English is correct, more bad, dangerous than in 2024. So we should be prepared for the weather atmosphere, for the climate. It's not going to be the same in 2025. It's going to be triple worse than it is, than it was. And this rain that is falling every day will continue until December, and it will continue by January. And I don't know if they're going to be Harmattan in 2024 this Christmas time, but I bet you, prepare for the worst in 2025. You're going to have a lot of weather problem. And this weather problem does not really need much of a rain to cause flood. Only little rain will cause a lot of damage. And the Lord said that rain is a rain of judgment. So we should pray concerning the rain, the early rain in 2025. So let's keep praying for the mercy of God. And it will get to a season, the rain will stop. It's only going to be sunshine for 6 months, 7 months, even close to a year. It's the weather climate. So we should keep praying at the rest. And the Lord said in 2025, the world is moving into the second phase of the famine. Remember, is remaining 6 years. In some nation, is remaining 5 years. So in 2025, we are moving into the second stage of the famine that the Lord told you about 7 years. So I'm counting it for you who have like 6 years to 5 years to go. So in next year, 2025, we are walking into the second stage. If the first stage is like this, how will you see the second stage in 2025? We have to pray. We have to seek God for His mercy, and we have to ask God. The reason all these are coming, it is because of the judgment against the church. It is because of the criticism against His sons and daughters. It is because of the little way you have belittled God and the mighty ways you have belittled Him. He is proving that He is God. So in 2025, we are going to experience it. The second quarter of the famine season. And in 2025, we are also going to have what we call anxiousness versus patience. Where a lot of people said, I am tired of serving God, I want to serve the shrine. And you will see them, many people will be divided into the ancestral God in the place of service, trying to modernize it physically, and people will not be able to do anything. That's what the Lord is talking about. So let's begin to pray concerning that. And in 2025, in 2025, some nations will begin to change their currency. Some nations will begin to change their currency in 2025 to see how they can beat other countries to have the good nation. We must pray. When nations will be fighting for the currency to be better, some people will change the dollar rate, some people will remove some zeros from the zeros, some people will put some zeros to add to the zeros. So it's going to be up and down. So we're going to have a lot of change of money. And the World Bank will have challenge from 2025. Yeah, World Bank will have a very big challenge in the management system. There's going to be an error in the in that part of nations. Now I'm going to say this for the last time. I know they might not be happy about this. I'm saying they will never be, but I'm going to mention their names. Tell everybody that is using cryptocurrency to continue in 2025. The Lord said, I will give them what it takes to stand firm, and I will use it to bless people. And the other part that the Lord is talking about is, please, the staffs of Nigerian banks, be very careful. Your leaders have decided to say the bank salary is too much, so let us reduce work and make these banks digital bank like OPAY. They will try to make it much better for less workers and technology operation. We can call it technology. Is it technocraft? That's what the Lord is talking about. So you people should pray so that you don't go into what I call redundancy in 2025. I saw a lot of banks releasing their staffs. A lot of banks will reduce their staff in 2025. So if you are a banker in 2025, start looking for something else to do as a business or whatever you think you can do. Because in 2025, some banks will take their staff by surprise. In 2025 and in 2026, more bankers about to lose their job. So send this message to them in the place of redundancy, and let us also pray into some banks that we run into some technical challenge, that we hold some people money in 3 months, 6 months, and a lot of people will have a lot of blood pressure because of what the banks will be doing. There is a specific bank that will shut down for a while. I will not be specific with the bank. Yeah. Let's be careful with a red bank. You know what I call a red bank? You should know better. They are no more competent in their job. So be very careful. Are you getting what I'm saying? Be careful of the bank where you put the whole of your money. We're going to be having error and upgrade problem in banks in 2025. I'm not talking only in Nigeria, I'm talking about worldwide. There are going to be error and upgrade in 2025. So we should pray and put this money saver in different bank. Never put your basket, never put your egg in one basket. That's what I'm trying to say. So put this money in pieces, because I know this bank very well. There are only two banks in Nigeria that will shake, then other three will fall. But I'm not going to mention their names. I've called their names before. I've called their names before. So I don't want challenges and people say, oh, he spoke about our bank. He spoke about our bank. And in 2025, the rapture of death will come in the second stage. What do I mean the rapture of death will come? The person you saw this morning and you just go somewhere to buy something and you came back, they tell you the person has gone. By disappearance, by death, by unawareness. So it's time for we people to come to the place of God. Because a lot of rapture will take place. The people you saw are gone. The people you believe in are gone. You just saw the man now. You go to buy biscuit for you to come back. Oh, the man is gone. So we should pray and ask God for his mercy. Because this thing is a serious thing I saw in the vision. He said the rapture beginning from 2025. No man knows when God is coming. But rapture 2025. Where strange people, the least people you least expect, the Lord is saying, they will go home. That is what the Lord is talking about. So we should pray for God's mercy and God to help us. So the rapture of death 2025, the unexpected are going home, except those who are conscious in Christ. And in 2025, And I began to see that children began an attitude called the uncontrolled. Uncontrolled in 2025, where children all over the world, mostly in the United States of America, that a 13 years old is old enough to be a baby mama. That's what I'm saying, to be a father. In 2025, we are going to pray against it, which I call the self-confidence in these little children. You can never control children in 2025. Everyone will be fighting for their independence. So that's why we have to pray seriously, because in 2025, the children will be uncontrollable. And in 2025, we're still going to have more economic crash. We are going to have more economy crash. More what? Economy crash in 2024. These great nations that are doing well will begin to fall. While the bad nations, the small nations, they say they are bad, we begin to do well in economy. The great nations will be falling, then the smallest countries will be growing in 2025. So we should pray about it. And let's talk about the health insurance companies all over the world. There's going to be a lot of disappointment. There's going to be a lot of disappointment with your health insurance in 2025. There's going to be a lot of disappointment from your insurance company in 2025. Those in the United States of America and those in Europe. Let's also pray for the UK. They might be part of that, because the UK insurance, health insurance, have been doing well. But in 2025, will they do well? Let's keep praying for God to have mercy. Prophecy can be changed if you want them to be changed. We can only seek God to change the prophecy. So in 2025, your health insurance company will disappoint 89% people in 2025. Just know that is what God wants. Are you getting what I'm saying? In 2025. And in the same in 2025, people will say, why is this man not talking about good things? Good things is because if you don't hear the bad part for you to pray, you cannot know how to hear the good. So you are hearing the bad part so that you can be able to pray, to counsel, and to pray for the good part. So I'm here to tell you the bad part of 2025. Your job is to pray against it so that you can see the good part. Because if you want good parts, of course, there are bad parts. So what will make children begin to die in 2025? And I began to ask the Lord this simple question. He said, because they know nothing and they do not seek knowledge. So in 2025, a lot of young people will be sleeping and not waking up. Sicknesses will have in different age and all that. So in 2025, mostly it's for the Americans, children dying, adolescent age dying in 2025. And let's also pray concerning the same children. In 2025, we'll be seeing children, a lot of children will be having diabetes, heart problem, kidney challenges in 2025. The Lord is saying the world lieth in wickedness. All that in 2025. And in 2025, let's also pray more, because we're going to have a very high risk of kidney problem. Kidney problem. In 2025. Then in 2025, we should be very careful of the plastic food Americans will try to be producing. This plastic food will only create cancers for more people in 2025. I saw cancer spreading in a massive way because of this food process in 2025. A lot of plastic food will be made, and people, because agriculture, will die. Not really die, but we'll be a mess. So it is time for we to go and stick to the natural food that we know and plant. The Lord is saying in 2025, use your little backyard. Use your balcony, whatever you have, use it to plant crops, to eat. Because in 2025, it will be very worse when it comes to that. America, there is no hope for your 2025. You will go through the whole plague. America will go into plague in 2025. The hurricanes, the earthquake is coming. The coming earthquake in America in 2025 might get close to 300 yards. And the second one will come that get to 400 yards. The third one will come that will get up to 500 yards until the massive column, according to the Spirit, will happen. That one is over 600 yards, where houses will fall inside these buildings. And we're also going to have a lot of explosion in the United States of America. We're going to have a lot of underground explosion, underground fire outbreak in 2025. A lot of fire outbreak is moving to the world. We should pray. Why would fire outbreak to the world? So we should pray against fire outbreak. Churches catches fire, offices, schools, universities catching fire. We should pray concerning fire outbreak. And we should also pray concerning water scarcity and water purity in 2025. There's going to be a lot of water scarcity. All you will see is chemical water converting dirty to cleanliness in 2025. We should pray seriously for a clean water in 2025. That's what I have to tell you. The world is moving in the place of no freedom. The world is moving into a place of no freedom in 2025. You said you have a freedom of speech, but the last time I checked, you were in the prison, you were in the jailhouse. So let us pray concerning that. And I give my prophecy for 2025 concerning Nigeria in 2025. If we are not careful, that's what the Lord is talking about in 2025, next year. If we are not careful, we will walk into tribal war. And not it will, it must happen, the tribal war. A test of gun, a test of power, that is what the Lord is saying. There is one issue that will begin to happen in Nigeria in 2025. Things will be escalated. A little thing that should die will become a mighty thing of destruction while the worst is happening. They will create a lot of things to destabilize the people of Nigeria while the evil carry out plan will continue. So we need to pray and pray for God to help us. And in 2025, the war that is going to happen in Africa, Europe, everywhere will be a financial breakthrough. When there is war, there is financial breakthrough for other people. That's what the Lord is saying. So more wars in 2025 just for financial profit and for financial gain. So we should be very careful for the fights. We should be brothers and sisters as the Lord is talking about. I began to see something waving down the earth from the moon, from the other world. What they call it? Something, an object begin to fall down from up, and it's going to cause a very terrific accident on earth. So I don't know if it's going to happen in 2025 or beyond or after 2025, but let's pray against everything that is going to fall on the earth. That's what the Lord is talking about. We don't know the nation. I don't have any idea of the nation. And in 2025, France is going to have a lot of challenges, human disaster and natural disaster. The most beautiful places in France will begin to fall. That's what the Lord is talking about. And in 2025, there's going to be a lot of strange climate weather. Forecasts will tell you sun will shine. When it gets to the time, rain will fall. The opposite would always be the challenge. And the fall of a great man in the world. I won't be specific. The fall of a great man that will go and join his ancestors in 2025. And it will keep the world on a standstill for a minute morning. And also in 2025, the world will go through a lot of dam breaking. A lot of dams will be breaking in 2025. And there is going to be a planned coup in Nigeria. A planned coup in Nigeria. We pray that it doesn't work and it doesn't happen in Jesus' mighty name. We pray. And also a coup plan is about to take place in Ivory Coast. We should be also careful. As also a coup plan is also planning again. Sir, His Excellency Bayo, please, you have to be careful and you have to increase your security plan. This one is the worst ever coup plan that is coming against you in 2025. So Bayo, the president of Sierra Leone, you have to buckle up your shoe. The first one I said you will miss it. They came and I said, I told you it will fail. This one is 50-50. Double up your security and never you take things for granted. Yeah, a very strong one. It's coming. That's what the Lord is talking about. So that is in 2025. And in that same 2025, we are going to be seeing countries in the same coup plan in 2025. There's going to be a lot of coup plan in 2025. It will be attempted in Nigeria. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And in the vision, I saw a white British man. Listen, I said in a vision, I saw a white British man. And these white British men are with other white British men. And they say, let us go to Nigeria. Because there is one man from Nigeria in the midst that brought this idea. And they said, if we all come as white, we will be suspected. And this white man, who is higher than every other one, came into the scene. And other military men who followed him were all black men. And I saw four black men and one white man. And they came to celebrate. The Lord said we should pray against coup. Because if the government, if the military takes over Nigeria, we are doomed. If the military takes over Nigeria, I say it again, we are doomed. Not for other countries that they take coup and the military take coup and it goes well and the government is trying. But in Nigeria, it will never, ever, ever be the same. So these British men and these four black men and the lady, they came for this coup plan. So we have to pray and stop it. We have to pray in 2025 and stop it. And in the same 2025, the Biafra will be given a document. A Biafra document will be seen publicly that is about to be published. But due to corruption and due to the same challenges inside the Biafra, they would not agree in signing that document. So I saw a document from Nigeria to the Biafra to go through it. But due to the corruption, that document was refused to sign. That's what the Lord is saying. So we should pray very well the Biafra will go in peace, but as I said, not for now. Let's pray against it. So that's what the Lord is showing me in 2025. And in 2025, we should be very careful of water poisoning. Water poisoning. So we should be very careful with water company. Water poisoning. That's it is. And the coming shutdown of nations. I cannot hear everything and say everything on a day. The Lord is saying, I can give the one I can give today, and we'll fix another day I can, like the way I did last year. So that is why I'm giving it bit by bit. That is what the Lord is saying. And in 2025, we're going to have a lot of short of currency. We're going to be having what? Short of currency. In 2025, there's going to be lack of currency. The world will really go into digital currency, where the cash will be lacking more. So the government will be finding it difficult to print more money. And instead of them to use more money to print more money, they will just go digital. So in 2025, we'll be having digital money over physical money. So most of you who have your currencies in your physical hand, it's okay. We will be buying more money next year if time is not taken. I'm not talking about Nigeria only, I'm talking about the world. The reduction of production of money will be more serious in 2025. So we should pray concerning that, and we should also pray concerning what God wants us to do. That is the most important thing. So do not frown your face, do not get angry. The joy of the Lord is your strength. In 2025 is going to be a glorious year to some certain people. Who are the certain people? The certain people are the people who believe in the things of God. The certain people are the people who believe in the love of God. The certain people are the people who have the faith of God. The certain people are the people who are investing in the kingdom of God. Not investing in the place of money, but investing in the place of themselves. In 2025, there is going to be an investment called the flesh. At the finance, the people who we invest in the place of the flesh will be protected, and the people who invest in the place of the finance will be increased and will walk in the place of favor. So if you are a human and you want to walk in this double path, so we're going to have investments with the flesh and investments with your money. So it's going to be for 2025, the flesh and the money. Investing in the place of your flesh is in the place of consistency in your church activities and in the things of God's kingdom. Then in the place of your finance, in the place of believing God for divine favor and continuity of his blessing. So these are the two phases of 2025 in the Christendom. And this is where we're also going to pray for the part of followership or falloutship. 2025, there is going to be more people who will come out to tell you and give you the evidence that God does not exist. In 2025, the people came out to tell you there is nothing like tithing and offering, and there is nothing like even God. But in 2025, there are people who are coming out bold to tell you there is no God. In 2025, people will come out on social media to oppose the pastors and say there is no God. What do we do then? Are you going to believe? That's why the Lord said in 2025 there is going to be a fallout and a falling. Why people are falling out? More people will be falling in. That's what the Lord is saying concerning in 2025. Nigeria will also go into protest in 2025. But as I said, it will never stand to be united. I wonder why protests will not be standing. The Lord said, I will never make their protest stand to come to pass until they stand with the church. It's as simple as ABCD. Since then, they're talking about the protest. Have you ever seen protest stand? It will never stand. It will only be a divisional protest, if there is any word like divisional. So that's what we're going to experience in 2025. And nationwide, there's going to be protests, including in America. There's going to be protests, the red and the blue. The immigrant, mostly in 2025, the American will go for the immigrant. So even though you are from Nigeria and you're a citizen of America, remember, you are not born America. You will be terrorized by most of the black in America. So let's keep praying and asking God for mercy in 2025. And in the place of Nigeria, we will be losing some high-ranking military men, some high-ranking Senate, some high-ranking officials to the president, some high-ranking advisors to the government. In 2025, a lot of high-ranking men in Nigeria will smoke out. That's what the Lord is talking about. I'm not talking in the middle of 2025. It will begin in the earliest of 2025, where we'll be having so many people get lost, dying, and missing. That is it. And in 2025, there is going to be a lot of poisoning. A lot of poison, not food poison, but there's going to be a lot of poisoning in 2025. So we should be very careful in where we eat, how we eat, and what it is. And in 2025, a former governor of Rivers State, Yenso Wike, and the current governor of Rivers State will be walking to the place of settlement. So whosoever is saying that these two people will never settle, I bet you, by the special grace of God and by His mercy, in 2025, they will be walking into the place of settlement between Wike and Fubara, the present and the current governor of Rivers State. And let's also pray, because whatever that we'll see today, which is the election, the local government election in Nigeria, in Africa, in Rivers State, in Port Harcourt, will be the same way that we want to apply in 2027. We'll decree, because a lot of funny things will happen in Rivers State today. Today is Rivers State election. Today is 2:05 a.m. I am saying it, so Osas, you're going to put 2:05. It's going to be so critical in Rivers State that we are praying that every death that is ringing, that is calling, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I decree that every order from Abuja that is to land Rivers State, we command you not to function in the name of Jesus. Every heartless human being they have sent to Rivers State, Port Harcourt, to cause havoc, I stand as God's prophet and I reverse it in the name of Jesus, that every court order must be listened to and must be obeyed. Every confusion that is coming to this state, my state, River State, Port Harcourt City, I decree into the villages, into the township of other community, that it will never happen. I decree it will never happen. I decree every citizen of this state, every non-citizen that is in River State, I cover you with the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Gunshot will never touch anyone. There is no robbery attack against anyone. It will not be used. This election today will not be used to embarrass our governor. This election will not be used to kill our youth. This election will not be used to cause chaos. In the name of Jesus, I put the governor of River State into the hands of God. Mr. Fubara, you are saved in the name of Jesus. the local government chairman, and all of you who are coming in your positions, whatever party it is, I decree none of you will be shut down. None of you will be killed. You are protected in the name of Jesus. Every plan of the enemy in this state, I command it right now to be silent. Let there be peace. Immediate peace, immediate effect. In the name of Jesus, every police in charge for evil, I command you, you will never have a mind of your own. The heart of a king is in the hand of God. I decree your heart not to fall into evil. Peace shall be in this state. In the name of Jesus. I cannot wait for another man of God to decree. I have to decree my state. There must be peace. There must be peace in River State. Every attack against the mayor, I come against it in the name of Jesus. No attack against you will prosper. No attack against the local government chairman that are entering will prosper. In the name of Jesus Christ, everyone who God has given the victory, you will win in the name of Jesus. There will not be any obstruction, distraction, collection. The ballot box is safe. If you touch it, God destroy you. In the name of Jesus, there shall be peace in the land. There shall be peace and settlement in the night, in the land. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' name we pray. And I go to the book of Mahama and Ghana. Mahama in Ghana is going to be winning. Yeah. Yeah, this is Mahama. He's leading. Mahama will be leading in Ghana. He will be leading. Close to the closing section. And the other man with stone cold will come and took his head. I took it from Mahama. That is why we should be prayerful. You understand? Mahama will be winning, moving forward, success. If he's not careful, another man will chuck his head. But I bet you that man, if he wins the president of Ghana, Ghana will cry. Mahama have a good future for Ghana. Mahama have a good plan for Ghana. Mahama is a good man. Mahama have a good things to do for Ghana. But the price Mahama refused to pay, and the pride, it's looking like he's late. But he will be winning. At the ending of it, I saw a head coming out, and this head took his position. Listen. Prophecy can change. Prophecy can what? Prophecy can change. But I saw Mahama leading in the ballot box. But at the evening time, that man took over. So what will cause him to take over and Mahama to lose? It will only take the mercy of God. It will only take the mercy of God for Mahama to win. Because Mahama will be leading in the morning. Mahama will be leading in the afternoon. Then between that kind of 2, 3, or 3, 4 downward, things will begin to change. Sometimes it can even get to 4. Yes, Mahama will be winning. It can even get to 4. But the moment is that 4. Things began to change. Results begin to, Mahama votes begin to fall. Other region begin to increase. Tension everywhere in Ghana. So it will not get to a time they will be moving the same log ahead, maybe by 1% ahead, small time this one, 2% log ahead like that. This is small space, just small gap. Small gap they just took. It might not be too much, maybe 1%, 2%. Remember, if Mahama can be humble and say, God, these things you said you would do for the church, these things you said you would do, if he can make that vow to do it for the church, he will succeed. But if you said no, then there is a problem. This vow, if he is going to fulfill it, yes, if he's going to fulfill it, then he will be. But if he's not going to fulfill it, God knows his heart. But as I said, Mahama will be leading until in the afternoon, evening period, his head took over. So we have to pray concerning what to. So keep the video so that you will tell people. Are you understanding what I'm saying? If only we pray for Mahama, ask for God's mercy, because Mahama is a rightful man to rule the country. But a rightful man sometimes is like this. Huh? It will take the mercy of God. It's mercy, nothing. All these things is mercy. It will take the mercy of God for Mahama to remain winning. He will win in the morning. As the votes go, Mahama will be winning. Mahama in the afternoon, the moment 3 o'clock reaches, Mahamas will be rounding up by 4. But things begin to change. It might even delay till 5-6 o'clock. Things change. So let's pray for Ghana. And let me tell you the worst part: if the other president becomes a president, if the other man becomes, okay, I will leave it for the next, for the next time will come. Life, I'll not say it. I'll tell you the 7 categories of the downfall of the other man becoming the president. I won't call his name. So when we come back for the next life, we will talk about it. So let's keep praying for Mahama. Let's keep praying for Mahama. I told you about the Israel, that more people will fight Israel, and they are fighting, more will still come. Nations against one for revival to take place. So the revival is coming from Israel, landing in Nigeria, establishing in the world. And I'm also going to talk about South Africa, the 20 things of South Africa that is about to come. Yeah, the 20 things about sacrifice. That is about to come. And let's begin to count our days of our Nigerian president. It's clocking 2 years by next year. I will tell you when we get to next year. What will happen to the Nigerian president if it gets to 2 years or 2 years plus? Remember, if you pray for him and you love him, God will act. But if you hate him with passion, God will keep him. You have the power in your hands. So next year we'll make him 2 years in power. There is something ahead of him in 2 years' time to come. In next year, that's going to make him 2 years. So did I say so? I didn't say so. But if you hate him so much that you are praying death against him, God said, I will preserve him. But if you leave him into the hands of God, pray, love him as a president, things will change. God does not work with your feelings. He doesn't work with your emotion. He works with his what? Instruction. So that is what I have to say. Thank you so much and have a wonderful night. I want to say God bless you in this month of October. That doors are opening. That doors are opening in the name of Jesus. Doors are opening. Doors are opening. Thank you, Father. And I saw door opening. I saw door opening. And the Lord is saying, tell my people to do this prophetic instruction. Use your door as a prophetic. Open, take the key, open your parlor door. Stay outside and pray. Open it from outside. Open it and say, Lord, I move into my year of prosperity, my year of longevity. It's a prophetic instruction for 2025. It's the Lord said, do it for 7 days. Everybody will open their sitting room from the outside. Lord, I am walking into my season. Are you getting what I'm saying? So every person will hold a key, a door key. Open your parlor door and you stay outside and say, Lord, I am walking into the prophetic. Yeah, that's what you're going to do. It's a prophetic. He said, tell my people. Yeah, he said, I am walking into my door. Yeah, of blessing. That's what the Lord told me just now. Open is a prophetic instruction. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So everybody stay outside and open. If you are sharing accommodation, just do it when you're all alone. Open it and say, Father, as I'm stepping into the parlor, as I'm not is about the house, as I am entering, as I'm crossing, entering through this door, I am entering into my season. And that's what we are going to do. And in this month, the Lord said, engage your family. Engage your family in communion. In communion. Engage. He said, my children, engage in communion. He said, I will protect you. I will do better things for you. Communion. That's what the Lord is talking about. You people should have communion. Have communion. That is what the Lord said in 2020 from now. This is not the season of surprise. Surprises will always be near. Communion, bread. Know about communion. Study communion before you do it. Don't just do it. Engage your family in communion. And this time the Lord said it's time for the people to go back and study the Bible. Live it as a lifestyle. That some certain things that is happening in this world can't happen to you. Are you understanding me? I'm studying on the word of God. Take your communion. That is the most thing. Worship. That's what the Lord is saying. Worship. Depend on your local kerosene than you depend on fuel. But fuel will still come down. Your great mighty schools will be attacked in 2025. So let's be careful the kind of schools we put our children. Great schools will be attacked in 2025. And let me give you this last one before I go. In 2025, one of these men that are fighting against doctrine and one of these men that are fighting for the place of righteousness, holiness, acting more better than every other one. This is self-righteousness and better self-doctrine between these people. I didn't say between this person. No, listen. Between these people, let's pray. Because I saw one going down. Yeah. Between these self-righteous people in Africa, self-righteous people, self-holy people in Africa, and these other people, so-called better doctrine, how it should be, what Jesus stands for, not what he has blessed us for. These two people, one is about to go, one of them is about to go, for the other one to recalculate his or her step. Yes, one is going to go, the other one is going to be cautioned and go back and ask God, am I really doing the right thing? Because the Lord said, you cannot mock the church with your human intelligence. He said, do not rely on your own understanding. That is what happened. In 2024, do not rely on your own understanding. That's what the Lord was saying. Thank you so much. God bless you. This week you are blessed. Go get your blessings. Go get, if it's car, receive it in Jesus' name. The fruit of the womb you have received. Job, congratulations. Engagement, congratulations. God's blessing upon you in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I remain Abel, and I want to say I love you from the bottom of my heart. In case of you want to support the ministry, Some people say, well, it was, yes, we'll pay. You see, the internet interrupted anything? No. I'm using, they call it the ZTE satellite. Support the ministry. Eh? My bank is Access Bank. Access Bank 0077534018. Access Bank. Support the foundation. Support me. I want to chop. I just am hungry. Support the foundation. Support my ministry. Eh? Support. Inbox or SAS for the paper. And God will bless you. Until Sunday, we meet again on Monday. I'll tell you the remaining prophecy. Somebody somewhere, Elijah, say, I love you. I love you too. Somebody say, please call it again. 0077 0077 0077 534018 Access Bank. Put money there. Access Bank. Use tap, send the money. Eh? I'll chop the money. Put it, let me go and feed the widows. Thank you. My one-on-one has opened. One-on-one has what? Opened. We are moving, they go criticize me. We are moving one-on-one from $200 to $300. Don't insult me yet. It's because of the school fees have increased. Yes. Somebody asks, you have time? I will have time. They have increased the school fees. Now the foundation will be paying 8 million naira every month. That's why we are collecting for one-on-one. The foundation will be paying 8 million for students. Eh? For students' handouts because they're on full scholarship. 8 million for school scholarship. Oh. Widows are inside. Scholarship are inside. 8 million. Man of God, I have a testimony. I'm too young to carry such load in the foundation. That's why we need the support. That's why I make it $300. So don't just call thief. I'm not a thief. For those school fees to be paid, eh? That $8 million in dollar, I don't know, but it's probably maybe like $5,000. Thank you so much. Appreciate you. Love you too. Good night.